Hello friends, welcome to Electronic Circuit Hub. So today we will learn about the ferrite bead selection. Okay, so today we will understand how do we select the ferrite bead for any particular application. Okay, how do we calculate the impedance of an ferrite bead? What is the insertion loss model? So all these things we are going to learn today itself. So basically, ferrite bead is a passive component which is widely used as a EMI suppressor, right? It is also called EMI suppressor, right? So let us understand, right? The first question arises here is why do we need ferrite bead, right? Why is ferrite needed? This is the first question. So let us understand why is ferrite needed. So you can see this plot here. Okay, this plot is for radiated. Let us say this plot is for radiated emission, and if you want to have a look, you can look CISPR 22 standard for RE. You can go there and you can find the limit for passing criteria and limit for radiated emission. So okay, so the frequency for radiated emission is given for this CISPR 22 standard is given starting from 30 megahertz to 1 gigahertz, but it is also subdivided into two parts, right? The first part start from 30 megahertz to 200 megahertz, right? This is 30 megahertz to 200 megahertz, and the second part is 200 megahertz to 200 megahertz to 1 gigahertz. So in the radiated emission, we have to limit our radiation below the limit line. So let us say this is the limit line, which is started from this scale is dB microvolt per meter, and this scale is for frequency in hertz, right? So here you have got some limit line which started from 40 dB microvolt for this particular frequency. It is 40 dB microvolt, and for let us say after 2 megahertz, 3 megahertz from here, this is around, let us say, 250 megahertz. From here to here, there is a change in limit. So here 40 and here 50, it is around 47. So the frequency starting from 30 megahertz to 250 megahertz, your emission should be limited below the 40 megahertz, and there should be also a passing criteria, internal passing criteria, which you also want to be below less than 6 dB. That means if you pass, you have to pass your radiated emission starting from 30 megahertz to 250 megahertz, your emission maximum should be a 34 dB microvolt per meter. Okay, so 34 dB microvolt per meter, that says you are below 6 dB below your limit line. Okay, now starting from 200 megahertz to 1 gigahertz, this is the RE band, and in that particular band your limit line is, this is 47 dB microvolt, right? 47 dB microvolt per meter. Okay, this is 47 dB microvolt per meter, and this is 40 dB microvolt per meter, right? So starting from 250 megahertz to 1 gigahertz, your emission should be limited below 47 dB microvolt, right? So if you have some internal standard, let us say 6 dB below the limit line, so you have to limit your emission at 41 dB micro volt. Hope you understand what is radiated emission and what is its limit line and what is its standard. Now we will talk about the ferrite bead selection, right? This was the basic thing I wanted to make you understand. Now there is a model, there is a loss model in ferrite bead which is called insertion loss model, right? Insertion loss model. So in the insertion loss model, you have a source voltage here, right? You have a source voltage, you have your source impedance. Source voltage is given by Vs, source impedance is given by Za, and your load impedance is given by the Zb. Here, this is the load impedance, this is the source impedance, this is the source voltage, and in between you have insertion loss model, or you have some impedance which attenuate the source signal which is coming from the source and going to the load. You have kept some ferrite bead, so the impedance of the ferrite bead is given by JF. So you know there is a source impedance ZA, there is a load impedance ZB, and now you have the third impedance which is called ZF. It is the impedance of your ferrite bead, right? Now the insertion loss says that the attenuation which is denoted by A in dB, the attenuation which is denoted by A in dB is given by 20 log ZA plus ZF plus ZB. You know, this is ZA, this is ZF, and this is ZB. So the insertion loss which is denoted by A in dB is given by 20 log ZA plus ZF plus ZB divided by ZA plus ZB. So since you know your source impedance, since you know your load impedance, and you also know your required attenuation, you can find the impedance of ZF. That means you can easily find the impedance, how much impedance is needed for your ferrite bead, right? Hope you understand this formula. The insertion loss in dB is denoted by A, and that is given by A equals to 20 log ZA plus ZF plus ZB divided by ZA plus ZB, right? Hope you understand this formula. How does it come from? Now your intention is to calculate the impedance of ferrite bead. So ZF is given by 10 to the power A divided by 20 into ZA plus ZB minus ZA plus ZB. Now you have to know the impedance of your source and the impedance of your load, right? So you can see the ground plane impedance is given by 1 ohm to 2 ohm, right? If you have some ground plane, that impedance is given by, if you are connecting your ferrite bead in a ground plane to somewhere, that impedance is given by 1 ohm to 2 ohm. If you are putting your ferrite bead in VCC line, that impedance is given by 10 ohm to 20 ohm. And if you have some clock line or some data line, that impedance is given by 50 ohm to 90 ohm. And if you have some long data line, for that particular data line, your impedance is given by 90 ohm to 50 ohm. So you have here all the impedances. Let us say you are putting your ferrite bead in a VCC line. Okay. So here, if you see, the impedance of VCC line is given by 10 ohm to 20 ohm. So I will take this example and I will solve. I will calculate the impedance of ferrite bead. I will solve by using this formula and I will calculate the impedance of a ferrite bead. So let us say ZA is given by ZA equals to ZV equals to 10 ohm. That impedance is for that impedance is for VCC line. Okay, so this thing you have got, right? So let us say you have your any application which says that you required attenuation of 20 dB. Okay, you required attenuation of 20 dB at 2 megahertz, right? 20 dB at 2 megahertz. So now you want to select your ferrite bit for this to get this attenuation at that particular frequency 2 megahertz, to get 20 dB attenuation at that particular frequency 2 megahertz, right? So you know this formula, right? You know this formula of insertion loss. By using this formula, you can calculate the value of impedance. So you know for VCC line, your ZA equals to 10 ohm, your ZB equals to 10 ohm. Now if you solve, your ZF equals to 10 to the power this, right? Attenuation 20, since your A is 20 dB, attenuation is 20 dB, which is given here, right? This is attenuation. So 20 divided by 20 into 10 plus 10 minus 10 plus 10. If you solve this, you will get 180 ohm. So one more thing I wanted to let you know in the first slide, right? The first slide. So the question here was why is ferrite needed? So you can see this is emission which is coming from your board or your application at that particular point of time. This is your limit line, and you can see for here it is crossing limit, for here it is also crossing limit, it is also crossing limit, and the maximum emission you have got is here for this point, and which is around you, if you say this is around 52 or 53 dB microvolt. Okay, so to reduce this emission, you need to have a ferrite inserted in your design, right? So this is emission, and this emission you have to reduce below this limit line. Okay, so that is why we need ferrite bit in our application, right? So let us move ahead where we were. So here you have got a ferrite bit impedance of 180 ohm. Now the last thing remain is you have to choose the ferrite for your VCC distribution which impedance is 10 ohm. So you have to look the graph of impedance versus your attenuation or impedance versus frequency graph of your ferrite bit, and this is, let us say, this is the VCC line, VCC impedance line. So you can see to get 20 dB attenuation and to achieve at 200, this is 100 megahertz. So this point would be 200 megahertz, right? So this point would be 200 megahertz. So you can look at this point where you are getting 180 ohm resistance. So let us say at this, the impedance of your ferrite bit is 180 ohm. So you can choose 200, choose 180 or 220 ohm impedance of your ferrite bit, which will able to suppress the noise 20 dB below at 200 megahertz. So hope you understand how do we select the ferrite bit, what is the application of ferrite bit, what is the radiated emission, what is insertion loss model, and how do you calculate the impedance of ferrite bit. Okay.